It's Kyle.
It's Jesse.
And we thought we'd do something a little bit different, which is maintenancing. I can't spell it. Half the time I can't say it. But we both just got back from a club race.
We did.
My car in particular might need a little bit of love.
It started out as a fully functioning car. I should know that because I maintenanced it.
It looked pretty not terrible at the start of the night. And now it looks like the scene of a hate crime. 18 minutes of on-track action and, oh, it's bad. So, got to deterred that. I thought, you know, Jesse has his process, and as you'll see, it's okay.
It's a little less shitty.
I have my process, which has been honed through years of mediocrity. And we're going to share that, and I'm going to share that as my gift to you. But before we get to the actual, you know, maintenancing and wrenching and all that stuff, anytime I'm about to work on an RC car, I need to focus. First thing I do is I reach into my pit bag and I pull out the sauce. Because if you're going to go on track, you always got a sauce. And I think if you're going to do any proper maintenancing, you always got a sauce. So, cheers, motherfuckers! Yep, I'm ready. Let's get this going.
All right.
So my pit bag literally has been sealed up like King Tut's tomb since the Wednesday race. I haven't looked at anything. I rolled in at, 1 a.m. because we go to the bar, midnight, whatever it was. We go to the bar afterwards for some healthy food and adult beverages. And, haven't looked at it. I haven't thought about it. Typically what I do is wait till about 10 p.m. the night before the next race. Before I do this, but for the purposes of the YouTube and all you fine people watching, both of you, we're doing this now during the daytime.
So, always come prepared with a koozie.
Oh.
Always.
Is that, you just have a koozie in your pocket? Yeah. Just cuz?
Yeah. Why wouldn't you?
Well, I keep this in my pit bag. It's almost effective, so I guess I can't judge.
The KC Daylighter koozie is premium. I mean, just look at that. That is...
Yeah, it's probably older than you.
What are you trying to say?
I'm saying he's about 8. I have to get a note from his dad to take him out of town.
Just because early release today.
Does your daddy know where you
Shut
are?
Shut up. Get out of here.
All right. So, okay. Here's me opening my pit bag just to give you an idea of the magic in my process. Opening my pit bag as it was when I left the track.
And here is a clip of me opening my pit bag. This has not been opened since I came from the track. And just a little bit of how I pack my shit.
I don't see any difference.
Oh, I see a difference. What we're going to do is we're going to pull out our cars and our tools. We're going to lay it out on the pit mat. We're going to compare and contrast. I'm going to start first. Here we go. We have one pit board.
Oh, as an aside, one of my favorite things to do with that pit board is to pick up whatever filth is on my car that falls off when I have to replace a part, and I put it on his pit board when he comes back.
I swear to Christ, if you do
this. He loves it.
My Titan tools.
Oh.
My car. Various cleaning products. We'll start from there.
It's a beautiful satchel you have. Is it a Proline MERS? Is that what it's called? Or does it have like a fanny pack, little clip-on? You could just put it on?
It's a satchel. Indiana Jones wears one.
That's a MERS. And he can do that because he's got a bullwhip. And height.
What do you got?
Oh, time for me to get set up?
Yep.
Okay. I'll get a pit board. Simple. Yeah, racing. Aluminum pit board.
Yeah! Racing.
And because I value efficiency... My tool setup is a bit more organized for rapid deployment, so I just put it all right there. Oh, that's a snack. Keeping that for later.
Is it a special snack?
And no edibles.
Oh, man.
We're ready to go. Although, nice push. Fucking savage. I am going to take a minute to organize my workstation to my liking. One sec. So where I like to start after a hard night racing is a post-race inspection. Now, Jesse has corrected me in the past and said it's not a post-race inspection, it's a post-carnage inspection.
Post-mortem.
Either way, I thought it would be good to take a look at my ARC R11F front-wheel drive. This is a fresh paint job, courtesy of our buddy Jeff Johnson. It was an absolute thing of beauty. I say was. It's seen some things. Again, this has 18 minutes of timed running on its life. You see, we got a little love tap there. Don't know how well you can see the front end. That side's pretty good, but this side, this side's caved in completely right there. What can I say? This thing finished the main, not driving straight. It came into contact with just about every car on the track except the leader, multiple times.
Can I comment on your wheel wells? Your rear wheel wells?
No, you cannot.
I think I'm going to.
See these?
Oh, that's fancy. All right.
Fuck.
So the fronts aren't bad, right? I mean, you know, they're not great by any means. But look at the rear. Look at that. I mean, it's like...
You could see my house from here. Well, once it sets on the ground,
it's like
it all
cutting an apex
up.
And then dropping back down. Now, I'd like to say that both sides are the same, but they're not.
Sorry, Jeff.
We appreciate you, Jeff. All that you do for us.
In my defense, I did not have at my disposal those cool wheel arch cutout tools, and I was repositioning the body a little bit farther back, or farther forward, rather. If I'd had those, I would have had nice round wheel arch cutouts. But, as it turns out, right after I finished the last cut, I found a set of wheel arch cutout tools that I had purchased and forgotten about. So maybe next time. If I can find them. What about your car, Jesse? What's it look like when you come back from a race?
Well, this is what it looks like when I come back from a race.
Without wheels?
Yeah, I take my wheels off. Makes for easier transport.
With a wrench?
Ready to go?
I do want to call out the livery on here. Custom Shit Show Island with the Racer Underground sticker and the new Shit Show Island logo sticker. Excellent.
Mike at Boom RC, you rock. Thank you for gussing up our Shit Show Island logo and making it less janky.
And while we're doing call-outs and thank yous, I do want to thank Jesse for going through and, using his words, defuckifying this thing before the race. He went through it, gave it his seal of approval, or whatever that's worth. And when he does do those things, he goes ahead and he tags them with, you can kind of see it on the chassis there, a nice little Racer Underground sticker. I thought that was a nice touch, but it's me not wanting to leave things alone, so I added my own touch, which is on the underside. When it's upside down and a marshal is going for the car, the Shit Show Island sticker. So, you're all welcome. Yeah, I don't take the wheels off unless there's a detached part from the car.
Lyle has a no body clip rule at race days.
Oh, just for the Mini. I can't actually charge this thing with body on. But
if you could, you would.
Oh, absolutely.
All right.
But just to be clear, the no body clip rule is as follows. It's like Formula One and Parc Fermé. Once you get to the track with the Mini, when the clips go on, they don't come off unless something's broken. And if it's broken, chances are I'm not going to bother fixing it because it's just too much work. Those clips stay on, and you turn the car upside down, and I've actually got the balancing port for the battery available on the underside of the car so I can just plug it in upside down, charge it, flip it back over, stick the bullets in from the top, throw it on the track. Ta-da! I've actually gone, I think, 4 race nights. It's 18 minutes a night times 4 nights without taking any of those body clips off that thing.
Now, the funniest thing about all this is when he actually has to work on that car.
Oh, it's so annoying.
You ever seen a pile of ants and you scare them or like you do something and they all kind of scurry around everywhere, but they don't really go anywhere in particular? It's like Kyle. He'll sit there at his desk or at his pit table and he's got to work on it, and it's like the twitches start to happen and he kind of walks around in circles and he... What am I supposed to do?
I find it hilarious.
Prick. Admittedly, I haven't done this whole maintenancing thing all that much, so I have no idea what comes next. Jesse, what comes next?
All right, where's your car stand? Do you have a car stand?
That's perfect. Oh, doesn't balance for shit, though.
Don't ruin the drink. Take your tires off.
Let me get a car stand.
I heavy sigh a lot when I race Lyle. Also, when we shoot videos, I heavy sigh a lot.
My name's not Lyle.
It's Lyle. Nobody calls you by your real name anymore.
I know.
That's what's beautiful about it.
Okay, so fun fact. If you go on rcscoringpro.com and click on the Seattle RC Racers Hangar 30 track listing in there, you'll get to see our on-track triumphs. Okay, you'll get to see our lap times,
trials and tribulations.
But you will not find Jesse or Kyle listed in this season's race results.
No, you won't.
Jesse thought it would be funny to fabricate a name for me, which makes no sense whatsoever. What is that name, Jesse?
Lyle Alfredo. I don't know where the Alfredo part came from. That was Todd's thing. But Lyle, that was me. That was all me.
And what do I say? I say, my name's not Lyle, prick. However, as irrelevant as that name is, we've assigned Jesse a new name as well. So if you were to look for Jesse's times in stock touring, you would need to search for Horse Jockey. And I don't think I need to explain the relevance of that.
Now that Lyle has his wheels off.
My name's not Lyle.
It's Lyle. we're going to talk about his race pubes.
Speed pubes, please. They're not as good on this car.
It's because I cleaned it. That's why.
Yeah, but the Mini. For you fine folks watching at home and on the toilet, I am willing to break my body clip rule and show you speed pubes. Hold on. If you thought my other car was fucked up from racing, get a load of this thing. It's seen some things. The body has leprosy. Yeah, you can see it. See, hello. You can see through the body. It's bad. But this thing says a special secret. This thing is damn near untouchable at our track. It is so freaking fast. And my secret is worth
what track are you going to?
The one in my imagination. This car has a special secret pro tip that's worth 1 to 2 tenths a lap. Guaranteed. It starts in here. See in the inside of that body? Yeah. That's black carpet fibers, shock oil, tire sauce, hopes and dreams. We call that race pubes.
Back here on yonder shock, I don't know how well you can see that. Well, it looks like we got buckwheat in a headlock there. There's a little bit of debris. You know, it's not what I would call clean,
but it is what I would call fast. And typically when I have to maintenance the thing or, you know, put a shock back on that exploded and puked all its oil off the track, I do my best to gather up lovingly all those race pubes and put them back on the car to ensure that the speed tip stays intact.
Here, hold on. We've got a nice little handful of it here.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Race pubes. There's a wad I just took off the body there. That's what I'm talking about.
All right, you know what? Get the...
Oh, no! Wait, this has got to go back on the car. Hold on. Race pubes. It's a thing.
For science.
You're welcome, Internet. Okay. What are we doing?
You need to clean your car.
First off,
before I touch it, because I will end up touching it, because you don't know what to do, I need you to clean your car.
It's clean.
It's not clean.
I
can't see my solder joints because there's so many speed pubes all over them.
There's solder joints.
That was clean when I gave it to you.
Yeah?
I just gave it to you.
Are we soldering today, Jesse?
God, I hope not.
So why do I need to clean it? I'll have to get my glasses. I can't see it. Looks fine to me.
Just lost 2 tenths. Lost 2 more tenths.
Slower by the blow, Jesse. So you're telling me first steps to clean the car.
Okay. Yes.
All right. I'll knock some of my speed off. Sure hope it's worth it. Can't make you any slower. Wheels are off. Race pubes shaved. What now?
I want you to detweak your car.
What's amazing about that is when you build my car, I don't have to detweak it. And you know why?
That's
because none of the fasteners are tight enough for the chassis to hold any tweak.
Oh, don't even. Don't even.
His nickname used to be Loctite because he would be dropping screws like they were freaking souvenirs.
I raced for a certain company that had fastener issues. That's what I'm going with.
I'd say he's got tiny wrists and he just can't get them tight enough.
Fuck you.
So detweak it. First thing we do is count the screws and make sure that the...
Yeah, they're all in there. Trust me.
That's a first. The last time you went through this car.
Yeah.
And I raced it.
Yeah.
And I didn't maintenance it.
Yeah.
Because that's just not what I do. And I took it to the next race.
Yeah.
Sitting between rounds and I actually had some time. So I got out this thing. I don't even know what the hell it's called. I got this thing and I started putting it on these little screwy things and messing around. And after I tightened three, a good half turn, I flipped it over and looked at the bulkheads, only to notice that one of the bulkhead screws was completely gone and then one of the bulkheads was cocked off. If I was going to detweak my car, and I am, I loosened the top deck screws.
How are you going to do that? Are you doing it the right way?
I don't know. So I do the top deck, the bulkheads, wiggle, 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 wiggle. Set it down, tighten it up.
Did you clean off your pit board before you did that?
No. Why would I do that? I'm not worried about dirt.
Or your speed cubes are contributing to your tweak.
Hold on. I'll clean it out.
No fucking hell. Oh, I hate you. Lyle did his right. You loosen your bulkheads, loosen your top screws, do all that shit. So as much as I rag on Hootie and X-Ray in general... Martin Hootie, he had actually a pretty cool video, you can find it on YouTube, about how to detweak your car using droop locks. So you find two spots in your chassis that don't have screws touching the droop locks. You set your car down. Simple. You loosen your top deck screws just a little bit. Just crack them. Okay? Just enough. So everything's loose. Top deck's loose. Give it a couple small taps, and then tighten it back up. So the droop locks keep it off of a flat surface, which is kind of like this pit board is old and janky and terrible, and it's not exactly flat. So the droop locks help keep things flat and in order. So when you're done, your car is... flat.
Ta-da!
You got an actual tech tip off of this video. Remember that.
I'm editing that out.
All right, so next, we are going to check bearings because Lyle hit a lot of shit on Wednesday.
A lot of shit hit me. I've said that. Pay attention. Which bearing are we looking at?
We're going to start with the fronts because fronts take all the load.
Load.
Do you know how to get to the bearings?
I know you've got to disassemble perfectly good front ends in order to get to them.
Are they perfectly good? They should be. I check them like 2 days ago, I swear.
I don't know if the bearings are any good, but I will tell you that there's certain elements of the front end, like this here spindle, that appears to be kind of movie. Oh. So before we get to the bearings, you might want to check for broken parts. Remember I told you this thing didn't drive straight when I, for the last, I don't know, 3.5 minutes of the main? There's your problem right there.
Well, that's...
And do you remember the ding on the body that I showed you a few minutes ago?
Is that on the same side?
That's on the same side.
Oh, yeah. Your shit broken.
I'll take this apart. We'll get to the bearing. Maybe even replace the broken part while we're at it.
That's pretty good.
My car's broken. Walk it off.
Rub some dirt on it. Yeah, I, in Chilliwack, I sent that little thing.
Thank you.
broke one of these, and I'm driving the car, and it's funny. I think I probably said the same thing you did. That seems not driving straight. It's driving like shit. I must have tweaked it. So I come back, and I'm checking things out. I detweak my car. I'm like, oh, I must be it. And I put everything back together, and I'm sitting there bullshitting with people. And it's maybe about, I don't know, 20 minutes to race time for me. And I look down, and I'm like, huh, that's got some extra play in it. Huh, there's a broken part there. So 2 hours of bullshitting turned into 20 minutes of thrashing to the last qualifier. That was my trip to Canada in a nutshell in November. I'd like to think I have more to do with my car, but I really don't. The problem is, if I touch this car more, and I fuck with it and I try and change setup stuff, it gets worse.
Hard.
I have a car that works, and I've been told by Corey, stop fucking with it and just drive it.
Yeah, I've heard some people make comments behind your back about how you fiddle fart around on stuff. Can't leave it alone.
Who said that?
Okay, everybody.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that a thing, or are you just doing that for video?
No, I've heard that.
Oh, man. I keep thinking there's more, and it's really great. I just need to drive it better. Which is, you know, that's generally about what? I mean, that's like 80% of all RC racers.
Shut up and drive.
Just shut up and drive the stupid thing.
So, my wife took over the music and locked the door.
I gotta pee.
We're fucked. Good news! I came prepared. I replaced the C-hub, checked the bearings. Bearings are good. Sweet Dion's on the radio. This is why I drink. I'm right now putting the dog bone with the little crazy plastic doodad back in there, and I gotta say, this bothers me. This is a pain in the ass trying to get the little blade lined up in the hole and get everything right. Any tips?
Blades are a bitch. No, there is no real tip to it.
No, thanks. I thought you were gonna be helpful.
Did you?
Nope!
I saw it right there, and I was like, oh wait, he forgot something.
Pro tip.
Yep.
Parts that come out of the car. That's awesome. Need to go back in.
Shims need to stay where shims were.
Fuck.
I'm done with my maintenance, so it's up for yours.
This is why I don't do maintenance, Jesse. I can't see shit right now. I just need to do LASIK, but I don't want to be out for like 6 days or 4 days or whatever it is while you recover. It's like, okay, do I want to burn essentially a week's vacation to stay at home with my eyes closed? If I want to sit around with my eyes closed, I'll go racing.
I was going to make a comment that you were Stevie Wondering down the straightaway. A la Jerry Boyle. So Jerry had a reputation of being, quote-unquote, the hardest pass in all of motorsports.
Yes.
If you got on Jerry's ass, he would Stevie Wonder. He used every inch of the space in between the two walls. And if you were so bold, if you were so brave to try and make a pass, wherever he was going before, he changed directions and came right at you. Now, this wasn't... Jerry's not a dirty driver. He just made it extremely difficult. Tonight's episode is sponsored by Red Hook's El Sonido Mexican-style ale.
Muy bueno. Muy caliente. A little taste of sunshine in rainy, shitty Seattle. Also sponsored by Maker's Mark.
Fills you up, never lets you down.
Pinky's high, bitches. Okay, so got the C-hub replaced. Bearings are good. Give them a spin. No crunchy crunchy. Everything's good. What's next?
We are going to check your shocks.
Oh, I have a way of checking shocks.
By all means, let's see it.
I focus on efficiency. So I go around, and I give each shock a little listen. What I'm listening for is not that usual little squeaky squeaky like some of you fast guys get all worried about. No. What I listen for, and I'm not hearing it yet, is best described as a toilet plunger being thrust into about a gallon vat of chili. Sounds a little something like this. And if I hear something like that, then I'll bother taking the shock off and topping it up with a little bit of oil. You're welcome, Internet.
Now, you don't want to know why you don't hear that on your shocks?
Why?
Why do you think? I want to hear your opinion on this.
Well, usually I'm half lit and listening to music when I'm working on it, so I ain't paying attention.
Okay. Who was the last person who built those shocks?
Yeah. Other than that, I mean, for me, because it's me, I usually check on my welding joints, make sure they're still good, no wires are falling off. We have seen my wires, especially on the front-wheel drive car, come off the motor. That's no good.
Refer to the Nora video for video evidence.
Yeah. Booger welds for the loss.
So we have fixed Lyle's weld joints. I think we may have shown this before, but that's an actual solder joint.
It's welded on there. Like, it looks like somebody cares.
Somebody did care. I don't know why. After that, I think we just put it on the setup station and give it a once-over, and you're ready to go. This is a record for you. You are ready damn near 2 weeks before your next race day.
Yeah, I'm going to have to fix that. I might have to re-weld this motor or something.
If you touch that welding, I swear to God.
Oh, I know. Something we missed. Bodywork.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on. Ta-da!
Good as new.
Fix that. Well, man, is that it?
I think we need to do a salute to the corner marshals that help our racers.
Hardest working men and women on the track.
You help fix body tucks.
They're the only ones on the track.
You help flip our cars over.
You'll know it's mine. Because of the sticker.
Don't yell at your marshals.
Be nice to them.
Unless they deserve it, though.
Because here's the thing. If a marshal's slow getting to your car through negligence of their own or waiting for traffic, or because they've got a physical ailment or malady, always remember, the reason the marshal is waddling over to flip over your car is because you fucked up.
You done fucked up, Aaron.
And what do we learn today, kids? Just don't fuck up. So here's to you, marshals.
You're the heroes of the track. You always have been, and you always will be. Cheers to that.
And you're the only ones getting any physical exercise racing toy cars.
I think that's it. We've maintained two cars. Well, there wasn't much to do on mine, but...
Well, there's always something to do on mine.
Yeah.
I'm the gift that keeps on giving. So, yeah, if you like what you see, and I know you don't, there's a thing to subscribe.
Punch one of the things on the bottom.
Press a thing, do a thing. We don't make any money doing this, but we have fun. That's always worth a laugh.
Yeah, it's enjoyable.
You can come find us on the Faceballs, The Racer Underground.
At The Racer Underground. Instagram. We have an Instagram. Ooh. At The Racer Underground. We appreciate all five of you that watch these videos. We really do.
We have fun. We've got a big old list of ideas on things that we want to do, but better than that would be if you guys have suggestions. Post them in the comments. We are always looking for new ways to embarrass ourselves and break shit. So give us your worst.
On behalf of all of us at Shit Show Island, good night and good luck.
Cheers.
Is we're going to each pull out our shit, respectively.
Whoa, word choice.
Context.
We just got to... We're going to hold mature audiences tag on YouTube with that, you idiot. Fix it, Jesse.
Let me slip my tool into your hole.
Zero Pittmans. Ooh. That's worth 6 seconds.
At the hand of a marshal. You know, I was going to say, this pawn gets... higher and higher every time.
It's because it's just about maxed out right now.
Yeah, she's engorged.
Swollen.
She's swollen.
Moist and swollen.
Moist and swollen. There's moss growing in places moss shouldn't grow.
So moist. The moss is supple. Logjam in take three! Try that again. Just gonna whip it out.
Not a mess.
Zip. Reflects our race programs.
If okay. You could call it that.
Program.
Race programs.
Oh, race.
Jesus Christ. Okay. Ow now, brown cow. Ow now, brown cow. Just a tip. Don, are you watching this?
Hey, cheers, Medea! Buddy.
We appreciate you. You gotta really get into it.
Put the hands out.
I hate you. I really hate you.
Lyle Silva away! Anything else you want to bitch at me about?
Probably our best work. Well, there's a lot. I mean, do we have time?
No, it's a 20-minute video.
Anybody remember this? We're still working on this. The ANAL technology has stood the test of time. I think we're just about ready to go into production.
New product alert?
New product alert.
Go on!
Okay. It is a hoodie.
I do love me some hoodie.
Hoodie. It's hoodie hand warmers, and you put your radio inside of it. So your shit stays warm. It's fancy. It's pink. It's probably about $2,000.
Can I get it monogrammed or my name on it or anything?
I think you can. You can get everything else monogrammed.
Alfredo's Race 2. Hey, Coco. Say something interesting while
it's like a woman saying take your pants off. Just do it. You don't ask questions.
I haven't heard that in years. Neither have I. Is it the same thing as leave me alone? Go to sleep? Get shit off my desk. Fuck, mine's broken. I'm just about broken too. You still here?
It's over. Go home.
Get a hobby.
Get off the toilet already. It's been 20 minutes.
Oh. You got some shit hanging down that is not supposed to be there. Get that looked at.
Wipe. Get out.
Log jam and take four.